Hey, pop quiz. Who's president? I know we all know, but there is actually a thought process that has to kick in before we can answer that question now. Since Obama and McCain are just looming so large in our consideration of the presidency now, and frankly, because the only response George Bush can force out of the electorate in these last 100 days of his presidency is that just about every time he speaks publicly to try to calm our fears about the financial meltdown, the stock market tanks. But hey, W is the president, and the most important initial thing defining the 44th presidency of the United States will be the imperative of cleaning up the wreckage of the 43rd. It's kind of a good mnemonic, actually. Wreckage. The W is silent. Academy Award-winning director Oliver Stone's new movie is called W. It hits theaters this Friday, just before we collectively decide who should be in charge next. The film puts a cultural capstone on Mr. Bush's legacy. Here's a scene where top administration officials discuss the hunt for weapons of mass destruction in Iraq.
My office sent to you spy satellite photos that showed that WMDs could be hidden in caves that you never responded to.
We analyzed those photos, Mr. Vice President, and they are actually trenches, watering holes for cattle, not caves.
That's not what my people told me.
Mr. Vice, you grew up in Wyoming. You should damn well know cattle. I mean, there you go. You fool me once, shame on you. Now fool me twice, and you can't get fooled again.
That was, of course, Josh Brolin as President George W. Bush and Richard Dreyfuss as a terrifyingly accurate Dick Cheney. Joining us now is Academy Award-winning filmmaker Oliver Stone. Mr. Stone, congratulations on the successful reception of W thus far. It's nice to see you.
Thank you, Rachel. Nice to be here.
It is clear that this film is not a simple criticism of George W. Bush. Watching it, I felt like it was a narrative, complicated character study. Do you think that we need to understand George W. Bush, the man, in a deep, complicated way in order to understand how he has functioned as president?
I don't think he is a deep and complicated man. I think he's a profoundly narrow-minded and provincial man, but I do think we need to understand him, because I think we need to understand why we elected him, how we got to where we are at this crossroads and what we're facing. And frankly, if we don't look back at the recent past, how do we learn from it?
Does the fact that we did elect him more or less twice, and does the way that he has governed tell us something important about who we are as a country, where we are as a country?
Absolutely. I think it's a mindset that we elected, and I think a mindset of force and muscularization, militarization of our policy. I think that George Bush represents a cowboy ethic, and I think John Wayne, it comes to mind, when I was a kid, he was a big movie star, but his politics were reprehensible to me and to many people. But he was endearing and warm and charming on the screen. Even when he was wrong, he would never back down. Americans kind of like that in films like Red River, dead wrong, but he stuck to his guns. And Bush has maintained that kind of denial. Richard Nixon was never able to do that. Bush was always, you know, what did I do wrong? And that attitude of the unexamined life, I think, is astounding to me.
One of the things that I found myself thinking for the first time when I was watching the film that I'd never really thought before was about what W might do after the presidency. And watching the film, I almost felt like maybe he's going to be one of those former presidents that does want to sort of go away, that does want to get out of the public eye. In terms of the way that you really portray his character, he wanted to be president because he wanted to win. And because he wanted to avenge his dad, and because of all these other personal factors that you don't necessarily get the same satisfaction from as an ex-president.
Very good question. You know, he'll build a library and there'll be nothing in it, as they say.
But, maybe he won't want to be in politics anymore. Maybe politics was about winning.
No, I seriously doubt. I do think he will be a force on the... Even Harry Truman, when he left office, had very low polls. But Truman reemerged as a very significant figure. He spoke up. And I remind you, Harry Truman had very much the same attitude as George Bush, which is, you know, he dropped the atomic bomb on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, and he said he never lost a night's sleep over it.
I know that, as far as I understand it, you were in the same freshman class at Yale as George Bush.
Yeah. I didn't make it, though. I didn't finish.
Well, your paths diverted famously. I mean, you ended up going to Vietnam. He very famously did not end up going to Vietnam. In some ways, when you look at the films, the historical films that you have made, Do you feel like you're sort of an archaeologist of your own era, of your own lifetime, that you are telling your own life story through the cultural and political touchstones of your time?
You know, what else can I do? That's my minor contribution, is to go through my life and respond the way I do, viscerally and emotionally and somewhat intellectually, to the issues of my time, Vietnam and the Kennedy assassination. It's what else do I know, you know?
Yeah.
I do know Vietnam, and I have a sense of these presidencies. This has been extremely difficult 8 years for me and many Vietnam veterans, because I did 3 movies about Vietnam, and none of them worked in the sense of stopping us from repeating very much a similar pattern in Iraq.
Mm. Well, I will say that I was born in 1973. Platoon came out in 1987?
Six.
1986, so I was 13 when it came out, and it was formative for me in terms of understanding what shaped the world that I'd been born into. So it's not just your life, it's all the American lives.
I really believe in America. I love the sense of initiative and freedom. And at the same time, I just wish we're a little bit more conscious about what we're doing. And I think we made a vast mistake in the last 8 years. I really do. But I think, I pray that with Mr. Obama, or whoever wins, Obama or McCain, they're going to have a hell of a hard time changing the direction of where we are. We have still a preemptive policy in place, which declares basically that we are the dominant military presence in the world, economic, and we will take on any rival that emerges.
That's, even a preventive war, to prevent rivals from
emerging.
There's
no way we can afford to with this present situation.
Yeah.
I think the economy will speak for us, but you know, everyone's saying it's such bad news, but you know, it might lead to some belt tightening and perhaps some restraint in foreign policy.
Changing of our horizons and what we think we can accomplish. One last question on that. I imagine that it is no coincidence that you made this film very quickly and that it's got a release date before the election. You are hoping that this is on people's minds as they vote?
You know, I did 3 movies about Vietnam. It didn't do much good. So what can you say? You don't do a movie for that reason. Short term, I'm making the movie for 20 years. I'm more worried about what's going to happen in 2020, 2040, and who are we going to elect next?
Hmm. Well, it's a thin and fuzzy line between changing the world and changing people's minds. Oliver Stone, it's
Thank
a real pleasure to have you here. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.